This week, many people living in our major cities, they've experienced disruptions to their daily routines, and it's all due to this protest group called Extinction Rebellion.
That's like a Hunger Games type,
though. It's full on.
Holy crap.
All week, this group, they've been carrying out a series of different protests. Mm. So this includes flash mobs, sit-ins and marches. And they say it's to bring more attention to issues like climate change and biodiversity loss.
The things that you mentioned in the protesting, it's much more extreme than that, isn't it?
It is. They're calling their tactic of these protests peaceful civil disobedience, which, if you don't know, that is defined as public, non-violent, conscientious breaches of law which aim to change government policies.
Oh, they make it sound so pretty.
They do. However, if you've managed to catch a lot or any of the coverage from these events this week, you'll see that they're anything but peaceful, I'd say.
Pretty extreme.
Pretty extreme. Many arrests have occurred and a lot more are expected. The group argue that these chaotic and disruptive actions should be assessed against the bigger picture, which is the issues that they're protesting for.
So they're saying what they're doing is such a minuscule impact compared to what the environment's currently having.
Exactly. And whilst I agree with the need to tackle these issues, I think they are huge issues all across the world, I just can't get behind the ideology of the behaviour of this group. I just can't condone it. I believe there's a way of getting a message across without gluing yourself to a road, blocking traffic in city centres, rolling makeshift barricades in front of cars, and scaling bridges like we've seen in Brisbane.
Although that was a pretty cool theme park ride that a guy made on the bridge. I wanted to try that.
I don't think
it looked pretty fun.
You would survive up there.
Nah.
In my opinion, this is only going to alienate people who might have been open to discussing this issue and these causes.
Whereas the protesters are saying they think it's going to do the opposite, don't they? They
exactly.
think, okay, we disrupt them, they might actually think about it.
This is going to
causing more anger.
I think it is.
Separation.
Just yesterday in Brisbane, and this is what really fired me up about this, is that climate activists targeted the city's public transportation system and blocked health and emergency workers on their commute to get to the major hospitals on Brisbane's main busway.
Oh,
so
no.
This busway, if you don't know, it services three of that city's major hospitals. And witnesses said these buses were full of health and emergency workers trying to get to work to help the public. And in particular, there was a surgeon who was supposed to be performing surgery at 9:30 in the morning and couldn't get there because these climate activists were stuck on the busway.
Wow.
And so I'm sorry, but when these seemingly peaceful protests are starting to endanger the lives of Australians and preventing our own health and emergency workers from getting to work to help them, I think enough is enough.
I'm going to put you on the spot here.
Oh, no.
Sorry. How else can we go about it?
I just think...
in a more civil manner.
In a more civil manner, I think that they are reveling in this chaos that they are causing, and that is just, for me, not the way to go about inciting your government to act on these things. It's going to put people off. It's going to put policymakers off.
That's we're already seeing that with who's the Queensland Premier?
Anastasia Palaszczuk, the Queensland Premier, is bringing in laws, fast-tracking laws to jail these protesters.
Okay, so it's having an adverse effect already?
Exactly. So I think people can have these opinions. Obviously, like I said, this is a huge issue.
Yeah.
We do need to tackle it. I just don't agree with the way that they're going about it.
Well said, Bunt.
Thanks.
Got fired up a little bit there.
Oh, I need to calm down.
You're wearing the leopard print top today.
For
showing your row side. Oops. What have I done here?
Oh, no.
On Hit 99.7.